This afternoon, of course, in the news, the Debenhams name has been sold for £55 million, but it's still set to vanish from our high streets. Yes, it means 12,000 jobs are set to go, and the stores in Sheffield and Doncaster as well. Kate Hardcastle is a retail expert. Good afternoon, Kate.
Hi, Howie. How are you?
I'm very good. Hope you are as well, Kate. What's your reaction to this news then?
Well, I understand why some people might find it a little surprising. Boohoo Group are very much known for fast fashion amongst a 16 to 24-year-old age group. But over recent years, they've bought brands like Coast and Karen Millen, slightly more upmarket, slightly older customer like me. And they've been successful in being able to take everything they know about online retail and apply it to those brands. Now, this is a big step for them. They're going to be moving away from just fashion. I would imagine the department store is going to have beauty, elements like that online. But I think they're doing it very purposefully to try and target a slightly older customer that's really moved in great numbers online due to the pandemic.
So you've no worries at all about becoming a monopoly as far as fashion's concerned. I mean, Oasis, Coast, Karen Millen, and now Debenhams.
Well, many brands have had multiple brands for many years in fashion, Arcadia Group being one of them, Phil Breen's brand, Evans, Dorothy Perkins, Topshop, Topman. So I don't think it's too dissimilar to that situation. The fact is, when you're working internationally with supply chains, the logistics of it are significant and everything's about buying in volumes. So it's about buying as much as you can to try and get the prices that you want and pass them on to the consumer. That was my job for many years. So I think it's always going to probably happen in that industry. I think it's about making sure that these brands are accountable when it comes to ecological, environmental, ethical and authentic trading. That's what we want to make sure. We want to make sure that everyone is playing their part in trying to encourage us as consumers to buy the right things and do the right things.
Let's talk about a couple of the Arcadia brands that ASOS have decided that they want to go and buy and snap up Topshop, Miss Selfridges as well. It is interesting, isn't it? Do you think this is a formula that's going to outmaneuver the traditional stores on the high street?
I think traditional stores on the high street, the future is going to be one that you and I have spoken of before over the last decade, which has got to be about a greater retail offer, better service-led, more vibrant today. But it's probably realistic to expect there's going to be less space taken up by retail on our high streets going forward. And it's going to be more about balancing those social activities in there too, be that the dentists or the nurseries. I think in terms of online, the fact is, when we're researching consumers, those that have moved there in great numbers due to the pandemic, due to not being able to get to non-essential stores, aren't really thinking of moving back to traditional bricks and mortar stores anytime soon. So I think we do need retail as a traditional bricks and mortar offer, but it's going to be a different offer going forward. And I think I've made my peace with that. What I want to make sure is that consumers get excellent no matter where they're buying from. And as I said, that those organisations are held to be more accountable for the way they do trade with consumers.
Kate, great talking to you as ever.